and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a full-on glam holiday look for you. So, yeah, in the classic red... Right. In the classic red and green shade of Christmas, I even match my clothes and my earrings with it. I'm also wearing regular old sweatpants, but we're just going to ignore that. Just pretend that I'm wearing like a really fancy shirt or a pair of leggings or whatever. Yeah. You won't see it anyway. Anyways, this look as opposed to the look I think I posted last week. Not sure which day, but anyway. As opposed to that look, this one is a bit more... It requires a bit more skill, not necessarily time, because it is still the sort of look that you could easily do on Christmas morning or whatever holiday you're celebrating. Because it is actually surprisingly easy to do, but it does involve huge eyelashes and a double wing. And, you know, it involves a little bit more skill. So, yeah, but it is a lot of fun to do, so let's get on to it. Now, I've already done my eye primer, because we're gonna start with the eyes as usual, because really, I will definitely get fallout all over the place otherwise, because I'm me and I'm not careful. For my eye look today, I'm going to use the Blood Money palette by Jeffree Star Cosmetics, because I wanted to use green, and I collect the palette, so why not use this one? If you don't have this one, of course, you can use things like Urban Decay is like around the same price range, or for cheaper stuff, NYX Cosmetics has really good eyeshadows. So does Kiko Cosmetics, which is also very affordable. Even Catrice, like it can be hit or miss sometimes, but they do also have a lot of good eyeshadows as well. But yeah, anyway, green is going to be the theme here. And I'm going to use my technique again with a brush and just holding it next to my eye to get a nice shape in it. But with a twist, I'm going to angle it a bit more upwards than usual. Step one basically is, I was pointing at this eye, but like step one is actually this. This is not what's like covered underneath my natural eye color. Point being, yeah, like I said, the angled thing. As you can tell, if you watch my videos more often, I angled it way more upwards than I would usually do my eyeliner. Now, the tricky thing is to copy that on the other eye. But basically, I want to do my eyeliner. Why do I have a weird stain here? Anyway, instead of doing it like this, or how I would do my eyeliner, I'm angling it more upwards. Towards my eyebrow. Just checking if it's sort of the same shape. This feels very uncomfortable, but just ignore that. And then I'm just going to apply a middle green shade with a kind of large blending brush. And make sure you keep your palette, it is really an awkward way to talk. Anyway, wait, let me just... Okay, I think it helps. But just keep your palette on your lap or something, so you don't have to move too much to grab anything. Because every time you move, you're going to move around the brush that you're holding on your face. And you don't want that. Because then you'll move the eyeshadow around. So yeah, try to keep the brush at least in one single place. And just toss it on there, don't worry too much, it is uncomfortable, so you don't want to spend ages blending like this. Moving on to a smaller brush and a black shade with green I was gonna say something else. Glitter, I meant glitter. And I'm just applying that to the outer edge here. Dragging it into the crease. Not going too far. And just building up that outer edge. If you want it softer, you could use a darker green. And if you do want black and don't have a black with, you know, green glitter in it, and obviously just use a regular black, you won't really see, ow, much of a difference. Why do I always push so hard? Because if I don't, then I won't get a nice edge to it. Ow. Okay, I don't think I bruised myself. But anyway, I'm going to go back to the larger brush and just start to blend. And like I said, this is a lot more comfortable once you no longer have that other brush on your face, pressed into your skin, making a dent in it. Because I'm fancy like that. Trust me, when I do makeup on other people, I'm a lot more gentle. Just saying. Anyway, back to the smaller brush and just blending that top part there out. Just making sure I don't really have a lot of product on this brush anymore at all. Actually, I'm going to put a little bit of dark green on it instead of black. So I just have it blended there as well, instead of having a weird harsh edge. Basically, just go back and forth between your brushes until you're happy with it. And, you know, be a bit more gentle with your eyelid skin than I am. because I'm really not gentle at all. Then, as you might be able to tell, this edge is a lot sharper than this edge, so I'm going to go back into my eye primer. If you happen to have used an eye primer that's like, you know, not colored, then you could use a concealer instead. But I'm going to go in with a very, very sharp angled brush. Or not angled, like just sharp, just, you know, you can see what it looks like. But with that, I'm going to tap along the edge of this. Just to make the line as sharp as possible. And because we didn't put a lot of eyeshadow there to begin with, it's just going to cover completely. Okay, just for a fact that you should probably know. The first eye is going to go quick, the second eye is going to go not very quick, because you're going to have to mess around with it until it's even with the other eye. Anyway, then it's time for a sort of highlighting shade. I thought it was an off-white color, but it's actually a almost glowing green, which is nice. But I'm just going to apply that on the part that we kept bare. And don't worry about where you're going to put the eyeliner, because the eyeliner will get over it. Practically, I mean, like psychologically, it might never get over being applied over green eyeshadow. That just sounded weird. That wasn't even funny. Anyway, yeah, then we have that. And then with the same shade, I'm going to apply my brow bone highlight, because why not? I really usually do that matte, the brow bone highlights. But I feel like we kept this here all matte as well, so far at least. So I feel like we can get away with it. Now, the non-matteness is going to be in the other part of the eyelid, the inner part. So I was actually contemplating doing a cut crease at first, but then I realized we're doing a double wing here, so a cut crease might just make it a little bit too much over the top, maybe even for a holiday look. So instead, I'm just going to grab a glittery green on a soft brush and just apply it in a smoky way. You could apply a glitter primer before applying a very glittery eyeshadow, but my glitter primer, well, the bottle died and then the actual glitter primer dried out and it was a bit of a mess and yeah. It doesn't work anymore, so I'm just putting this over my regular primer, which is also fine because the primer I use is actually a Maybelline Color Tattoo and not an actual primer. But the point is that it's sticky enough that the glitter really shows up well, which is the entire point. Moving on to a paler shade of glittery green. And that's just going to go into the inner corner. So it's a little bit brighter than the other part. And then back to the middle-sized blender. And with that I'm just going to blend this upper edge out because I just don't like it when, like, either it needs to be a cut crease or it needs to not be a cut crease. I don't like it if I don't do a cut crease, but there is a random edge to the eyeshadow. So, yeah. Just making sure everything is nice and soft. Okay, that's on there. So yeah, next up is the regular winged eyeliner. And after that, I'm just going to quickly do my face off camera and I'll return to you for the eyes. Now, I'm just applying a red blush and I've also, obviously, the eyeliner turned out like twice as dramatic as I anticipated. Oops, but I like it. But I also did foundation, concealer, cream contour, and powder, so that's all done. But yeah, I want to do a red blush because I'm going to do red lips and I just think it suits very nicely together. So I'm applying about half a molecule of red blush on my cheeks because I'm a ghost and it can get very much very quickly. So yeah, if you're as pale as me, be careful with red blush. Then for highlight, I'm using one with a greenish blue glitter. Very carefully because, you know, it's festive and it's glittery, but I don't want it over the top. Now, for the under eye, I'm going to keep it quite simple. I'm just going to use a short stump brush, bit of a smudger brush, with the dark green shade. My other mirror was not looking at me. Anyway, how did I only notice that now? I have no idea. But anyway, I'm just applying this below my lower lashes, pulling it quite far inwards, but not too far. It's the sort of thing that you can also just cater to your own eye shape, you know. But anyway, then the same brush in the black eyeshadow, and very carefully I'm going to put it in the outer corner, connecting it to the wing. Again, be very careful with this, because with the entire face base done, fallout would be kind of dramatic. And then I'm going to use a... Let me just wipe that brush down. A small blender to blend that a little. I don't want it too far down, I just want it to be not too... not blended. Anyway, then for the inner corner I'm using the same brush with the white fluorescent greenish shade. The highlight shade from the brow bone and this negative space-ish part. And apply that in the inner corner. Now I'm just filling in the waterline with a black pencil. Also, by the way, in case you were wondering why my eyes look a little bit red, it's because it's, I kid you not, 10 before 6 in the evening. Yeah, stuff was late at work, so I was done with work very late, and I'd already put up my background system and all, and I planned on filming, so I was like, I shall film, no matter what, but my contact lenses have had it, so... Yeah, I am going to apply falsies, but I'm going to do that, like, at the final end of filming, because my contact lenses are not happy right now. So, yeah, the eyelashes, like I said, are going to go absolutely lost, so you'll see that in the show part. But I did want to show you the lips, because I'm going to use a very pretty color, which one by Anastasia Beverly Hills. Everything will be listed below the video, as always. This is actually normally in my professional kit, so I'm going to use it with a brush. I always prefer to use a sort of thick eyeliner brush for that. Just feels like it gives me a lot of control. Okay, so with that done, it actually matches my shirt really, really well. I like it. Anyway, like I said, I'm going to do the eyelashes last and then we're done. Did I already say that? I think I did. Anyway, but yeah, the lashes I'm going to use are very thick, long, fluffy foaming pair that doesn't stick on without glue, obviously. But anyway, if you're not comfortable with falsies, of course you can use either smaller ones or no falsies at all. But me personally, I just always feel like when I want to go full on glam, I want to use falsies. So yeah, gonna stick these on and then onto the show part. And that leaves us with the final results. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you celebrate Christmas, I hope you have a wonderful Christmas, with or without this full-on glam makeup. I mean, really this year, whatever. If you want to sit around in your sweatpants at home, you do you. So yeah, but anyway, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!